Hello friends, welcome to the official YouTube page of Everest IAS Academy. So today we are going to discuss January 26, 2020 Hindi newspaper analysis from the UPSC prelims 2020 point of view. So the first article which came in the headlines is India-Brazil Inc. Action Plan to Deepen Strategic Relationship. So basically friends, this we have already discussed. The Brazilian president has visited India for our Republic Day celebration. So he was the chief guest for this year. So as part of that, what our government has did is that we have concluded various, we have taken our relationship to the next level, and we have also prepared an action plan so that we can deepen our strategic relationship. So we have signed various memorandum of understanding also, so that we will actually, we wanted to work with Brazil in various fronts. So in that, if you see friends, regarding investment cooperation, we have already said a model BIT. So that is the model bilateral investment treaty. It is considered to be an like it is an alternative to FDI, like how foreign investments are happening in the country. It is an alternative. Only thing is here, what will happen means any disputes, our government will say that we will protect their foreign companies, Brazilian companies which are investing in India. In addition, what will do is any disputes happening means that will be taken not to the court in India, only it has to be dealt in the international arbitration center. And one more thing is, we are also planning to have this agreement in this bioenergy. Bioenergy means basically like India and Brazil, they are the leaders in the production of sugarcane production, and from sugarcane we are getting lot of ethanol. So they want to produce fuel through this biofuels. So that is where both the countries are actually looking for some agreements. In addition, they have signed some agreements regarding cyber security and social security. Social security we will discuss separate article friends, and regarding cyber security, and we have also signed mutual legal assistance treaty. Suppose a criminal, if he's committing any crime and he is actually going and settling in other countries, or suppose in Brazil, means we will have a smoother legal assistance in this investigation which is happening related to criminal matters. So next article is PMO reviews measures to combat coronavirus threat. So friends, we have already discussed the basics of coronavirus. Just we will go through that one more time. Basically, coronavirus is caused by virus only. It is not caused by any bacteria. If it is caused by bacteria, means we can use antibiotics. But in case of virus, antibiotics won't work. So we need to have a vaccine only. Till now, the vaccines we have not developed. So there is no treatment as of now available for coronavirus. That is why the world is having a lot of problem. In addition, the WHO has clearly said that there is a serious case of human to human transmission is happening in case of coronavirus disease. And this coronavirus origin, if you see friends, it initially originated in 1937. That time the disease started in birds only. Then it later spread to various animals, and that time it has caused one disease previously called in China, that is called as SARS, and one more disease it also caused in Middle East, that is the MERS. SARS will be usually transmitted from bats. And in case of MERS, it is transmitted through actually these camels. Especially these are available in the Arabian region, in lot of population will be prevailing. So from these animals, actually it has spread to humans now. And now human to human transmission is also happening. So that's why, in addition, why we are unable to find a vaccine for these diseases means because coronavirus, in that virus strain, it actually changes its strain very fastly. So it does its mutation very fast. That's why any vaccine, if you do for a particular strain, since it is dynamically changing, it's very difficult to find a vaccine for this coronavirus. So now actually the international, as of now, we can only prevent the disease. Only thing is, what we can do is we have to prevent the human contact, because it spreads through human to human contacts, and especially through the oral cavity, from the air droplets of the infected persons or any objects which have been touched by that infected person, it will spread to the healthy person. That is the mode of transmission. And even it also transmits through the fecal material from the infected persons, especially the excretory material. Through that also this virus strain will be there, and any healthy person comes in contact, we will also get the disease. So these are the basics we need to know regarding coronavirus strain friends. So as for that, actually till now there has no case has been reported in India. So but for that, our government is also doing many preventive measures. So for that, we are actually, our PMO office has given a notification. Especially they have actually created a separate helpline center for people, suppose any foreigners who have visited, especially the Wuhan, which is in China. This is the epicenter of this outbreak, coronavirus strain. So now any people who have visited this area and came to especially India, various states, if they are settled now, means after visiting China, especially after this new year, our government is keeping a close track upon them also. Next article is a bid to restore coral reefs in the Gulf of Kutch using biorocks. This biorocks is totally a new concept, friends. So in the environmental section, in the preliminary examination, there is a high chance for UPSC to pick questions either under environment or under science and tech column. So we need to know full details about these biorocks that we will discuss in this article. So basically what the, like it was, this initiative has been done by the Geological Survey of India. So now what they have did is, they have actually created this, they wanted to restore the health of coral reefs, because if you see coral reefs, they will be basically in the shallow water bodies of these ocean areas. Now what happens is that for them, the healthy temperature to prevail is only 21 to 27 degrees Celsius. This is a healthy temperature for a coral reef to to multiply its population. Now what happens is that due to the global warming which has been created by climate change and other factors, now the temperature has been increasing throughout the world, and due to that, these coral reefs, inside the coral reefs, if you see, there is a zooxanthellae algae is present, and when the temperature increases, means this algae will die and the corals will be it will suffer coral bleaching. A whitening will happen, from green to the white color change will happen, that we call it as coral bleaching. So this is what and why we need to preserve coral reefs, means from the environmental perspective, it is the one which has the highest biodiversity, lot of varieties of microorganisms, algae, fungi, like fishes and various marine animals. It is considered to be a rich habitat zone. That's why we need to preserve the marine habitat, especially the coral reefs, which supports the other organisms also. So that's why our government, especially the Geological Survey of India, it has it went for some technological innovation. Through that, we have found these biorocks. It is, other name is mineral accretion technology. So what here they will do means, so we will also discuss this with the help of a picture, friends, that will be give much more clarity. So basically what they will do is, they will place the solar panels on the ocean surface. Through that, the power will be connected, and that positive diode is called as anode and the negative diode is called as cathode. This we would have studied in science only. Now what they do is, through this, a small amount of electricity only will be supplied to these both the diodes. Now what happens is that in the positive cathode, we already have calcium ions, and this will attract the carbonates, and this will lead to aggregation of calcium carbonate. That rocks will be that will be generated here. It will be formed calcium carbonate, and through the calcium carbonate, now what happens is that this calcium carbonate is considered to be very healthy for the coral reefs to thrive upon. So they will come and make their habitat upon this. So that is why our government has, through the help of these biorocks, this is why they are calling this as biorocks. So through these biorocks, which are artificially created, where they will get these carbonate ions, means, friends, if you see inside the oceans, already lot of minerals are already dissolved in the ocean water. Through that only, there is a lot of minerals will be found, and through this cathode mechanism, what happens, it will actually, once the current is supplied, it will try to attract the positive ion. Since cathode is considered to be negative, it will attract the positive, and calcium has a positive. Ca2 plus is the formula for the calcium, and once it gets absorbed, means it will lead to calcium carbonate formation. Through this, we can make a livelihood, or a habitat can be generated for coral reefs. So this is the concept of biorocks. Now let's go and study the some other facts regarding that. So fragments of that broken corals, once a biorocks is generated, once it is created, means, now what happens is that upon that, the fragments of coral reefs, because already due to the coral bleaching which happened, many of the coral reefs are their coral reefs have been broken down. So they have been a fragmented particles in the ocean areas, in which only few marine organisms are living upon. Now once they get attracted to this, actually, once they see these biorocks, which is considered to be having a large amount of calcium carbonate deposition, they will make their habitat here, and this will ensure the faster growth of coral polyps. So in the coral reefs, we have this coral polyps organism, and we also have a zooxanthellae, that is the algae. So both these will try to regenerate upon this area, and if healthy coral reefs can be generated, this is the concept. In India, if you see, there are major coral reef areas. If you see minorly, if you see, means there are a lot of areas along the eastern and western coast, friends, but if you see the major coral area of reef areas, means they are found in Andaman Nicobar and Lakshadweep. So both of the islands they are found, and in Gulf of Manna, this is in case of Tamil Nadu and Sri Lankan region, that area we have the Gulf of Manna region. In that, it has a healthy coral reefs areas are found, and one more area is Gulf of Kutch. These are the four major coral reef areas. So let's study the basics regarding coral reefs also. So it is considered to be an underwater ecosystem, because basically if you see the ocean surface, these coral reefs will be found below the ocean water only, but it will be found at a shallow depth. So that is the concept. They cannot be found at deeper depth. Why? Because they need the presence of sunlight, because the algae has to do photosynthesis, and upon that photosynthesis only where various organisms like that coral polyps and even these fishes will make their habitat depending upon that. So that is why that photosynthetic algae will supply oxygen to this coral polyps organism to thrive upon. So that is why coral reefs are usually found in the shallow depths, and the other name is, it is also called as rainforest of the sea. Why? Because friends, if you see in the land area, tropical rainy forest only supports the richest biodiversity, but in the marine area, if you see, coral reefs does its function. That's why they are called as rainforest of the sea, and since it supports diverse habitats for various marine organisms. So as we have discussed, they are only found at shallow depths, and deep water and cold waters they won't be found. If they are found, they will be found only on a smaller scale only. So let's study the requirements for a coral reef to thrive upon. Basically, they need sunlight, and that too, that sunlight can be found only in the shallow water. That's why they are usually distributed in the shallow water area. And they also want a sediment free water, because if sediments are present upon the ocean surface, means sunlight cannot reach the zooxanthellae algae to do photosynthesis. That's why the water has to be free from any sediments. And they need the temperature. Ideal temperature is 21 to 27, and the maximum temperature it can withstand is 32 degrees Celsius. After that, the coral bleaching will happen. And then, as we have discussed, they need clean water free of any sediments, and they also need some salts to thrive upon. So that salt has to be nominal. So these are the basic criteria a coral reefs can thrive upon. So if you see in this picture, this is what this coral reefs is all about. So upon that, various organisms like marine organisms will make their habitat. That's why it has the richest biodiversity in the world. So kindly remember this, friends, because UPSC has already asked one question regarding coral reefs, and in that, one of the fact they have given is especially this one only, whether coral reefs have the richest biodiversity or not. Many people have committed mistake during that year. So kindly remember this, friends. Next article is, app aims to academically empower visually impaired students. So basically what happened is that the visually impaired students, what they happen when they want to write the examination, they are actually looking upon any other people only. Now in that the writing, the person who is coming for scribes, no, they cannot always depend upon. So what happened is that due to the development of one recent app, this is an Android based app which is called as Swellacon. Now what it will do is, it is nothing but a speech to text to speech app. So suppose whatever speech that person, blind person, wanted to do, when he is doing that, means that will be automatically converted into a text. So it will be majorly benefit this visually challenged person. So kindly remember, friends, the app is Swellacon app. Next article is, Bodoland area is said to be redrawn. So basically what happened is that under the 6th schedule of the constitution, so we have the tribal areas for which we have given special status, especially for Assam, Tripura, Meghalaya, Mizoram, and these are the states which have been given exemption from Citizenship Amendment Act. Also, they have been given exemption, especially because in Citizenship Amendment Act, non-Muslim communities who have suffered religious persecution from three main countries, Pakistan, Afghanistan and Bangladesh, they can come and they can get the citizenship. Only thing is, they have a cutoff date, that is December 31st, 2014. Before that, if they are here and if they don't have, like if they have the residential status in each and everything, they can get the citizenship. Now these people cannot claim that citizenship in the 6th schedule places. So in the Assam area, the tribal areas, especially the territorial council areas, there this 6th schedule won't apply. That's why what happened, now this borderland territorial area, they have their separate powers, because we have given them the special status under the constitution itself, in which they can determine, they can go and have taxes upon their own, through that they can raise the financial resources. So they have lot of liberty upon that. So now what they are doing, means they are actually planning to redraw the areas which have been under their control. So one thing is, in the autonomous council, they will categorize people into domiciles, means who are residing in that area and they have a genuinely citizenship, and they will categorize the people into outsiders also. Suppose any outsiders, if they are coming to this area, means, and if they are coming for work, means, they have to get a permit, only then they will be allowed. But one thing is, they will never get the right to vote in these areas. So one more thing with respect to this borderland issue is our Union Home Minister and Assam government has recently signed one agreement with this National Demographic Front of Borderland Progressive. With them, we have actually signed the agreement. That is a peace deal we have signed because they are considered to be a terrorist organization. We will study the basics also, friends, about this organization. If you see the Bodo card, its basics means first it was signed in actually 1993. Then what happened in 2003, we have given them some extra powers also. So every year they will actually revise this extra power. Like whenever the demands have been raised through negotiations, that power will be raised. So these things we have already discussed. What are, like, as we have discussed, the Citizenship Amendment Act will not apply to the 6th schedule areas. So let's go and study the basics about National Demographic Front of Boroland. So basically it is considered to be a terrorist organization. Why? Because they are asking for a separate country status for the Bodo dominated areas. They wanted to establish a separate area for themselves and separate country and statehood, they are asking. Now as of now, what happened, if you see in the history, this National Demographic Front of Bodoland, first initially its name was only Bodo Security Force. It was considered to be a militant organization when it was formed in 1986. Then what happened, it has went for various violence related activities by attacking upon the outsiders people and even the persons who are coming from Bangladesh and who have settled, those migrants, they went for violent attack upon them. So our government that time thought that we have to seriously control these people, especially the National Demographic Front of Boroland. So at the time they have designated them as a terrorist organization and they went and hided out in the, especially the Bhutan area. So that time what happened, with the help of Bhutan government, we went for an operation, that is Operation All Clear. So when we did that operation, these people came and signed a ceasefire agreement with our government. Then we went for signing a separate agreement with them so that we will be given them, like, whatever crimes they have committed, we told that it will be relaxed. So that time National Demographic Front of Boroland only split into two groups. One group was very ready to join the peace talk, that is the progressive faction. That only through that this organization only we have signed a deal now. And one more organization is National Demographic Front of Nabla. So this Nabla has been, now it has been dominated by, leadership is a non-Bodo, his name is Songbit, but he has not signed a peace deal as of now. Next article is Brazil vital ally in economic growth. So basically, as we have discussed, with respect to Brazil, we have signed a model BIT. Previously what happened, after the Modi government came into being, we have not signed any agreement regarding this bilateral investment agreement. But after that, this is the first time we are signing since 2015 with Brazil, because we wanted to take our relationship to the next level. So even we have signed a social security agreement. So here what they will do means, we will try to get the pension amounts will be generated in lot of amount in between these two countries, because it has a very good population and both have the same demographic profile. So both are the developing countries in the world. So now they wanted to, like, whatever pension funds they have, they can come and invest in Indian stock markets or like any securities market. This will be beneficial for our private business investment. That's why we are encouraging the social security agreement, and we have signed that also. One more thing, we have also created a separate body, that is the India-Brazil Joint Commission. This Joint Commission, hereafter it will meet every 2 years and it will discuss what are the actions we have taken, whether it is going in line or not, they will discuss here. Next article is China toll hits 41, virus detected in Australia, European Union. Basically, as we have discussed, friends, Wuhan is considered to be epicenter and this virus is spreading fast from human to human. If you see the countries, from China initially it went to neighboring countries such as Hong Kong it went, then Thailand, Vietnam, especially the Southeast Asian countries, Singapore, then Japan, South Korea, neighboring countries of India also, Nepal also got it now, and USA also. So next article is Gangaru Mother Care Improves Infant Survival. Basically, infant means it refers to a child who is up to 1 year of age. And there is one more term which is called as neonatal. Neonatal means a child who is born and having that up to 28 days, it is called as neonatal. In case of India, if you see, neonatal deaths are considered to be very high. That is why they say under 5 mortality in India is very high. The one among the reason is also malnutrition also. But now one more thing is, whatever birth rate we are getting now, the problem what they are saying means neonatal birth, especially up to 28 days, the serious issue is, we in India, whatever birth we are getting, basically they are having very low weight, especially the childs which are born. So they are actually having the high rate of getting, so they will die very fast if you don't take care of that low birth weight category, neonatal category. So now what happened, as part of that, our government has gone for Gangaru Mother Program. So Gangaru is a marsupial animal. It is found in case of Australia, if you see in marsupials category, what they will do is, it is also a mammal. It will give birth to young ones, and this animal will always carry their younger ones in their separate pouch like future which they have. So their government is actually going for the same mechanism. If in this picture, it will be very clear for you. Like a Gangaro, how it carries their child like in their pouch, our government is also promoting to carry the mother when they are giving birth. They want the child to be carried. They will tie up with like this. They will try to promote this skin to skin contact. Through this, what they are saying means, it will also lead to promoting exclusive breastfeeding will be done for the initial 28 days. And this will actually reduce the low birth rate issue. What is happening, the death rate can be solved due to this. And wherever, whatever surveys we have conducted, that is saying a success ratio improvement has been happening up to 30% in babies. So a baby which is born, like when it is less stable, they will say it is having less than 2 kg weight. For them only they are recommending this Gangaro program. So we will promote exclusive breastfeeding, and the duration for breastfeeding will also be increased. Until the child attains that 2.5 kgs, we will go for this intervention. So WHO has actually recommended the child should attain a weight of 2.5 kgs. Up to that time, it has to be this Gangaro mother program has to be done. So, and one more thing is, as part of the WHO has also said that mother can keep the child as long as possible in a day. So it is up to their wish. So it will prevent the child related deaths, especially the neonatal deaths can be avoided. Even up to 90% maximum coverage can be done. Next article is Nilgiri's high pesticide levels in potato carrot. Basically, friends, if you see the Food Safety and Standards Authority, this is the body which comes under Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. So this body only prescribes the maximum residual level pesticides for all the products which you are coming, farm products. But one problem is, it does not prescribe any standards for fruits and vegetables. And whatever survey which has been done by various NGOs, what they have found is, in case of Nilgiris, which is considered to be a hilly area where carrots and potatoes can be cultivated very easily considering the climate and agroeconomic conditions prevailing over there, so they were able to find it has a large amount of pesticides. So if you see the organopastropesticides, friends, kindly remember these pesticides, because in examination recent times they are asking these pesticides name also: acephate, malathion, profenophos, chlorophos, and then quantaphilos. So just kindly remember, if the name ends with FOS or FOS, so and these two names you kindly remember. So these will come under pesticide category. So basically they were able to find lot of these organopesticides in case of strawberry, potato, cabbage, cauliflower. We already know it, they will use lot of pesticides. Then carrot, garlic and broccoli, they were able to find lot of pesticides in all these categories. Why we need to protect means, as we have discussed, we need to protect the consumer's health. Thank you, friends, kindly subscribe to our channel. If you have any doubts, please post your doubts in the comment section.